Hi, this is Andy James and welcome to Guitar Interactive Magazine. In this issue, we're going to take a look at part one of a three-part tutorial on how to play fast. In this part one, we're basically just going to break down the mechanics of legato and alternate picking with a few exercises that I've learned over the years that have really helped with this technique. Okay, let's take a look at the first exercise. Okay, this first exercise is going to be in the key of E minor, and basically what we're going to be doing is just practicing our legato technique with our left hand. Now it's quite important to get it nice and even between the notes rather than concentrating on the speed first of all when you do this. And all you're going to be doing is just pulling off from the 15th to the 14th to the 12th fret with your left hand, and then hammering on 14, hammering on 15, then pulling off, and just basically cycling that round and round. Now what you're going to do is you pick the first note and then just rely on your left hand to continue the lick. And as you get more comfortable with that, just gradually kind of speed it up. But I wouldn't try and speed it up all in one go. I would just get really comfortable with the technique, almost to the point where you're completely bored of it and think, oh, this is just the easiest thing to do in the world. Because that's kind of where you need to be in order to break that speed barrier, especially with your left hand playing. The other thing to kind of take into consideration is when I do licks like this, I'm kind of pushing my first finger down quite hard and also pushing my thumb against the neck quite hard as well, just so I can get more leverage into the middle and third fingers. Then, you know, once you get more comfortable with that, you can start to extend it out a little bit. You can kind of do more of a pentatonic style shape where you've got your first position with a note from the second position as well, which will be the 17th fret. So you'll have 12, 15, 17, and then just do the same pattern. And then, you know, do it until you're completely bored with it. And obviously, you know, your left hand is going to get a lot stronger and a lot more familiar with playing that type of pattern. Okay, you could also practice picking that as well. A lot of picking I decide to do on the neck pickup just because it seems to separate the notes a little bit more, but it's entirely up to you what you want to do. And alternate picking almost always starts with a downstroke, and then you just basically alternate the strokes. So if you were going to alternate that pattern, you'd have something like this. Okay, with alternate picking, if you're kind of not really familiar with that sort of technique, there's a couple of things that maybe you need to try. The first of which being that you should always pick from the wrist and not use your forearm, because otherwise you're going to end up with some weird technical issues and also physical injuries as well. Things like RSI and stuff are very common injuries that you'll get, you know, with playing the guitar. So if you kind of pick from the wrist, you're going to avoid all that, so you won't end up in A&E or something. Okay, the other thing to consider is angling your pick. If you're flat picking against the strings, basically you're going to end up with so much resistance you won't be able to pick fast. The best thing to do is angle your pick, or find a really hard pick with a beveled edge, so it's quite smooth but maybe goes to a point. And you know, if you angle it, it will glide through the string a lot easier, and it will, you know, just basically sound a lot better as well. And the other thing to kind of consider as well is just keeping concentrating on your downstroke, because that's sort of your downbeat for it. So you literally, if you accent it, it will sound something like this. You know, and you can start to extend out the legato passage that we looked at as well, but you know, obviously you keep doing the picking. And basically you can kind of alternate between the two techniques then, so you really get, you know, to grips with legato technique and picking together. A good indication if you're kind of doing the legato right is if it sounds pretty much the same as when you're picking. because obviously if your legato is fairly weak, it's not going to sound at the same volume as when you're picking. So if you do legato and then pick, you should be able to hear no volume change in the left hand. You should only really hear the kind of attack from the right hand picking. Okay, so as you can see, if you you know, get that technique down enough, then you should be able to alternate between legato and picking. And you know, once you get really familiar with it, I mean, you're going to get so bored with doing things like this, but you know, it's not really about the kind of music at the moment. It's about getting your technical ability up to scratch.